I'm Tricia Stuth, and this is Robert French. We're from the College of Architecture and Design, and we're going to try to fit 2.5 years of A New Norris House into 20 slides, so wish us luck.
In 1933, the Tennessee Valley Authority constructed a model community, Norris, Tennessee, as part of the Norris Dam construction. A key feature of this no-deal village was the Norris House, a series of homes built as models for modern and efficient living.
Original Norris cottages took advantage of new technologies, municipal electricity, water, and sanitary systems. The TVA tested modern materials and innovative building techniques, yet Norris was not based solely on technological aims, but was also a progressive social experiment.
Upon TVA's 75th anniversary, a team of students and faculty won the EPA P3 competition. P3 refers to people, prosperity, and planet. It served as an ideal lens to revisit the Norris experiment and a vehicle to question the use and scale of public and private resources.
Norris is one of the first planned communities in the United States, and the plan of Norris provided the team with a series of lessons: compact houses connected by footpaths and roads to schools, services, and a central common. The town is bounded by a green belt that exists to this day and serves as an aesthetic and natural preserve.
The project entails the design, construction, evaluation, and demonstration of a modern dwelling for this century, and the process required that the team confront and resolve not only technological or scientific challenges, but also legal, social, and aesthetic issues that currently restrict green construction.
Progressive environmental design touches many issues and disciplines, and thus requires an integrated team to optimize results. Through this project, faculty and industry partners taught students to work in this way from concept through reality.
Industry partners include Clayton Homes, the nation's leading producer of manufactured and modular homes, headquartered in Alcoa. The team worked with corporate and factory teams to prepare and produce the home in 2 fabricated modules for transport and installation at the project site.
Students taught by faculty, research specialists, and trade experts prepared the site and foundations for installation of the modules and completed construction of the home and landscape. Combining on and off-site construction, the process engaged students through design-build curricula that enriched understanding of the interrelationships between both theory and practice.
The project is enrolled in the current U.S. Green Building Council's Green Building Rating System and is on target to achieve a LEED Platinum rating, the first UTK facility to achieve this top rating. The home's impact on its environment begins with where it is located and how it fits into its community.
The project replaces a neglected house, its footprint marked by the drive court, and it reuses a previously developed lot with existing infrastructure from the 1930s. The site is designed as an aesthetic and performative landscape through its approach to drainage, wastewater, rainwater, planting, and material selection.
The scale, form, plan organization, materials, and details of original Norris houses were examined and transformed to address the contemporary issues. The new Norris house is of similar size but exploits the full interior volume and enhances daylight and connections to outdoors.
Passive design encompasses strategies that do not require energy inputs and instead reduce demand and therefore systems loads. The new Norris house is super insulated with openings placed to enhance useful solar gain, natural ventilation, and daylight.
Passive design effectively allows downsizing of active or energy-powered systems. Efficient equipment is selected and integrated, including ductless heat air systems, energy recovery ventilation, and ceiling fans.
A solar hot water panel combines active and passive systems to heat and store water, and an instantaneous water heater provides makeup heat if weather and demand require. The panel's not visible from the street, mounted on a dormer that also provides light, air, and volume to the loft.
Gray water, wastewater excluding toilet and kitchen sink, is released into the first terrace and treated in a basin of mulch and plants before joining rainwater terraces that prevent erosion and aid infiltration. A path connects community walks, walking trails, and native drought-tolerant plants enhance landscape performance and experience.
Rainwater from the roof is captured and stored and treated through UV and carbon filtration for use in toilet flushing, clothes washing, and exterior hose bibs. Experimental permits granted by the Tennessee Department of Environment and Conservation and a monitoring period will evaluate suitability and capacity for potable use.
The design build team and the Clayton team reduce material use and waste during design and construction processes and adjusted supplier practices to obtain local and recycled materials. A healthy indoor environment benefits from daylight and views and avoids finishes with VOCs, volatile organic compounds.
The current phase of the project includes a residency. A married UTK couple resides in the house and participates through educational tours and blogs, sharing their experience living in the house and the community with both the public and the research team.
In addition to qualitative feedback, the residents' daily activities generate data on energy and resource use and occupancy patterns for analysis of the building's performance. ORNL's Building Research and Technologies Integration Center is assisting the team with digital data collection.
And you can see our website if you'd like to attend a tour for UTK faculty staff on Saturday, November 12th, where you can also sign up for information about auction of the property and live in the new Norris House after the demonstration, monitoring, and evaluation periods. Thank you.
Thank you.